Hello, I'm William Short of Hurstwic, and this is the first in our series of Viking combat sparring videos. In addition to our regular training at Hurstwic here in our training room, we also do special training exercises, which includes sparring exercises outdoors, sometimes on challenging terrain and sometimes in winter. We set up Viking Age fight situations and scenarios as described in the sagas, and then we fight them to experience as closely as possible historical Viking Age fight situations. One situation that's mentioned in the sagas has one group of men busily at work when a second group of armed men approaches, perhaps with a score to settle. Maybe there's been an argument over land rights, such as shared grazing land, or perhaps over found property, such as a beached whale. How do you deal with approaching armed men whose intentions you may not know? I'd like to spend a moment in this first video to explain our sparring conventions to you, so that what you will see in a moment makes sense. We use a three-hit rule. Three hits to any combination of targets takes someone out of the fight. But even a single good hit to a vulnerable target is considered lethal. Death is acknowledged by raising the hand and lowering the weapons. We fight full contact. Our blows are not pulled, and any target is permissible, although some targets are preferred, as indicated by colored tape on the modern protective armor we wear. Weapons are also marked with color tape to indicate how they may be used. For example, green tape indicates that the weapon may be thrown. Since fighters are free to use the terrain in any way they wish, potential improvised weapons are also marked with colored tape. For example, a rock on the ground that's marked with green tape may be picked up and thrown in the fight, but not something unmarked. The scenario you are about to see was the first we did using this set of rules. And so fighters are tentative in some things. And there are examples of fighters gaming the rules to their advantage. For example, using three quick taps to make a kill rather than three solid blows. Fighters sometimes do weird things or use strange combination of weapons to see what happens. We encourage this kind of behavior in sparring. Sparring is meant to be a learning experience and not a competition. So we want people to try new things to see how they work in the fight. A fighter who uses the same favorite weapon in every round will be asked to switch to something else. The fight looks scrappy. Our approach to sparring results in realism in the fight, and realism does not always result in beauty in the technical aspects of the fight. And so here, a Viking Age fight over found property. A beached whale. This was our first test of this kind of all-out sparring exercise using these rules of engagement. Fighters tried some moves and tactics that worked, and some that didn't. We all learned many things from this chaos, about our fighting moves and tactics, but also about running scenarios based on these sparring rules.